Green clumps of algae are among the many side effects of this year's extremely hot and unusually long heat wave in Korea. Algae blooms in different shades of green are clogging up rivers and waters in the southern parts of the peninsula, damaging the ecosystems and creating an unpleasant stench as well. But more Korean scientists are finding ways to turn a crisis into an opportunity. How they're using a health and environmental hazard to create biofuel and algae-based technology. Our news feature tonight with Oh Sooyoung.
Algal blooms have returned to Korea this summer, discoloring rivers, lakes and other waters with green, and giving off an unpleasant smell. Warm temperatures, slow-flowing water and excess nutrients like nitrogen and phosphorus cause algae to grow and thrive. Environmental groups claim that algal blooms have been rampant in recent years because of a controversial restoration project across the country's four major rivers that slow down the river flow. But experts say the reason is more likely down to the weather.
We saw very little rain in August, so the water was stagnant. We also received a lot of sunlight with the heat wave this summer. There's plenty of phosphorus in Korea's downstream waters for algae to bloom, depending on the climate.
Large clusters of algae can deplete the oxygen in the water, killing fish and other aquatic life. Also, some blue-green algae produce toxins like microcystin, which cause sickness upon contact and liver damage or paralysis if swallowed. Advisories and warnings have been issued for certain parts of the Dakdong and Kumgang rivers, where the number of blue-green algae cells have hit the thousands per milliliter.
No alerts have been set off so far for the Han River, the main source of water for more than 20 million people in Seoul and the surrounding area. Still, with alerts in effect for other major rivers in the country, area residents remain cautious about possible outbreaks on the Han.
I know there have been outbreaks in other rivers. If it spreads to the Han, I wouldn't want to use the water to wash or drink.
I've seen the state of the southern rivers on Facebook. Waters are connected after all, so I think it could affect the Han.
To keep the water safe to use and drink, water authorities have enforced various measures within the water treatment process to tackle the bloom.
Blue-green algae cells are removed through water treatment, and so are toxins, through oxidization using activated carbon, so the water is well treated.
Meanwhile, numerous researchers in Korea are turning the crisis into opportunity. The number of patent applications for algae-based technologies has risen to roughly 50 per year, a 50-fold increase from 10 years ago.
Scientists at this research center in Incheon have successfully converted algae into biofuel, which can be used in cars with diesel engines.
Making biofuel from grains and crops requires a wide stretch of land and fertilizer, which harms the environment. The Korean research team has become the first in the world to produce biodiesel using a cost-effective and environmentally friendly method. This involves placing naturally occurring algae, which absorbs the nutrients it needs, in a special cultivation system in the sea.
With our technology, carbon dioxide in the air and algae-producing chemicals in the sea are absorbed. These substances, which are considered environmentally damaging, are taken care of through the process. With some adjustments, this technology could be applied to rivers and lakes, as well as to purify the air and waters.
Meanwhile, another laboratory in Gyeonggi-do province treats wastewater using green algae that grows in sewage instead of harmful chemicals. With similar technologies developed abroad, it can take 4 days to complete the treatment process. But the Korean lab has reduced the time to just 12 hours, while producing much clearer results. Using their method, the algae contained in small pieces called moving bed reactors absorb the excess nutrients in the sewage water more efficiently.
The oxygen needed to remove ammonia is produced naturally by algae, so it saves a lot on costs and is environmentally friendly. Also, the residue can be used to make biomass, including diesel, ethanol and fertilizers.
With Korea's algae-based technology making groundbreaking progress, experts say the prospects are bright for commercialization at home and abroad, as global demand for sustainable energy sources and eco-friendly technologies continues to increase. Oh Sooyoung, Arirang News.